One of the things that's getting a lot of headlines, obviously, is finally the comparisons between Michael Jordan and Kobe Bryant. Fascinating topic. Don't worry, we'll get to Derrick Rose in a second. I think this has been a little misconstrued. It's not like you're picking one over the other. You're just talking about some similarities and differences. So why did you resist doing this until this point? There was a great anecdote. Mike Bresnahan, the Lakers beat writer, wrote a first-person piece saying he tried to get you to make this comparison throughout the entire time that he covered you and to no avail. So why did you wait to this point, and was that difficult for you to write about those two players?
Well, yes, it is. It's difficult because they're just a standard that's above in all cases. When I came to the Chicago Bulls, Jerry Krause, the general manager, and I talked a lot about our strategy towards winning. And he was always quick to tell me, there's never been a team driven by a two guard that's won a championship in the NBA. You look at all the teams that have won. They've had, you know, Cousy and Russell, and they've had, Oscar Robertson and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, and you get Walt Frazier and Willis Reed, and you had the Wilt Chamberlain, Jerry West, group. But there's never been a two guard that's been able to be the dominant force on a team that's won. And the reality is that I was able to have 11 championships working with two guards in each case. Now, that taking away a little bit of something from Shaquille O'Neal was pretty darn good center, right? But Kobe was still a dominant force on that team and just coming into his own. But it says something about the dynamism of these two guards that, in fact, Michael compares Kobe as the only one that he could really say met his standards as a player and a guy that worked hard at his game. And that's very true. They worked very hard. They're dedicated. And so I talked about that part of their characteristic that is so similar. But then I make comparison about Michael's leadership, which he had a little better temperament about because I got here. He's 27. He had gone through the University of North Carolina program. He had Sam Perkins and James Worthy on that team that won a championship as a freshman. He had made the key shot. The joke was, of course, that who could hold Michael Jordan under 20 points? Nobody but Dean Smith, because his coach would sit him, right? So Michael had to pay allegiance to a system and to a college that had great teams. And so he was willing and able to slip into what I asked him to do and we asked him to conform to run this offense that we were going to run. He had averaged 37, 38 points a game previous to that, and I asked him to point blank not win a championship in scoring. I said, I don't think there's been a scoring leader that's won a championship since Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. And I think he said, maybe Rick Barry. But then he said, I don't think it's going to be any problem. I can average 32 points a game and still win a scoring championship. So he had it all figured out. But I think the idea got to him that, hey, the ball's got to be distributed and other guys have to touch the ball and we have to have ability for other people to contribute because our defenses that are going against us can't all be focused on you because we'd run against the famous Jordan Rules defense that the Detroit Pistons had for the last 3 years and failed. So he was capable of doing that. Whereas Kobe was 21 when I got to the Lakers. He was a kid developing, never played college basketball, been a high school basketball player that could do what he wanted to do basically on the floor. And I asked him to be a point guard or to the lead guard, set up an offense that was going to feature Shaquille O'Neal. So he had to take a different role entirely. So we talk about those comparisons, and I think it comes out pretty even for both of them.
So Kobe or Michael?
Someone asked me to pick.
I know.
You see that one?
Yeah, I saw that one. Go ahead.
I picked Bill Russell. He's got 11 rings.
Smart man.